practice of triple talaq is concerned, that's been challenged in the Supreme Court. It's going to be heard on 11th of May by a bench of 5 judges. The Government of India has filed an affidavit supporting the challenge, saying that these practices are pernicious. These practices should not be allowed in a secular nation where there is no distinction between caste, creed or color or religion or of gender equality. Women have as much right as men. Both have fundamental rights and one cannot be treated on a lower pedestal. And this constitutes 50% of women of one religion. So can we have a situation where women of other religions have as much right as their spouses, but women of another religion who may be living next door or in the same house will not have the same rights? So according to the standard of the Government of India, these practices are unconstitutional. They should not be allowed. The women should not be treated in this fashion. It also amounts to disrespect. And that's the stand we have taken. Now, if the Muslim board also feels kind of that these practices are not good, this is a welcome thing. They should have the courage to tell the Supreme Court that, look, now the Supreme Court has to decide. There's one thing is clear. Yeah. It's not as if the case is going to disappear. Yeah. Because the case is on behalf of women. So it's not that it can be settled this way. They should, if they are willing, they should come forward and say that they also feel that the practices are pernicious and they are not a part of religion. And if that is so, then, things will go that way. But that can't finish the case.
So, do you think this will lead to a lot of dissonance going forward, given the fact that in the past we have seen these religious bodies be so touchy or prickly about such matters? Here we are seeing the Muslim Personal Law Board argue that this is protected under Article 25 of the Constitution.
Our stand is that they are not protected. These are not practices that which are essential to a religion, and they run counter to many, many provisions of the Constitution. They run counter to the very existence of women as equal partners in the march to success in a democracy which is secular, which does not look at color, caste or religion, and therefore these practices must be abolished.